So the first thing we need to do before we can deploy is make sure that we have an account on Azure. If you go to azure.com/free, then you can register for the free account on Azure. This will also give you access to free web apps. So beyond the first 12 months, you can actually run this app you've been working on the free tier. So once you've registered for Azure, the next step is to go back into VS Code, and we're going to install some Azure extensions. The Azure extensions for VS Code allow you to deploy directly to Azure from VS Code. So first of all, go to the extensions pane, then search for Azure. And the top item should be something called Azure Tools. This is an extension pack that includes all of the things you need to deploy and manage Azure from VS Code. So install that extension pack. And then once you're done, you'll get this extra button on the left-hand side, which is the Azure icon. If you go through to there, it'll prompt you to sign in for the first time. So sign in with the account you just created on the Azure portal, or if you already have an account for Azure, you can sign in using that existing account. Then our next step is to go to the component called the App Service, and we're going to create a new web app for our deployment. So click on this icon here, create new web app. And we need to think of a globally unique name for the new web app. This is unique across all web apps in Azure, not just yours. So I'm going to use Ant space Tours as the name for my app, and then press Enter. Then it's going to ask which runtime stack you want. So we want Python 3.8. And then you can pick a pricing tier. So like I mentioned, there's the free account that you've set up, but there's also a free tier in web app. So even beyond the first 12 months, this web app will be in the free tier. So we can pick free, and then we're going to get an update in the right-hand side about all of the steps as it creates our new web app. Okay, so once that's completed deploying, you should get this notification to say that Ant space Tours has deployed and the URL. If you want, you can click on the deploy button, but our app isn't actually ready to go into production yet. So we need to make a couple of changes before we can do that. Remember this URL here. So antspacetours.azurewebsites.net. So we need to keep that in mind. We need to make a couple of changes to the app before we go into production. One extra thing we need to do before our first deployment is add a extra application setting. So in the Azure panel, go to your app, which is called Ant Space Tours in my case, then application settings, then right click on this section, do add new setting. The name of the setting is a bit long, but I'll paste that in there. It's SEM do build during deployment. This basically says that once you've deployed your application, it's going to go and pull and install all the dependencies for you. So you don't have to log into the server and do that manually, which would be a bit of a pain. So hit enter, and then the value needs to be 1. And once you've done that, it will install all of the latest Django as well as white noise and do all that for you automatically. So let's now go to the folder view, and we're going to open up the settings file. Now towards the top, you'll see this big thing saying security warning, don't run with debug turned on in production. Now, since we're about to deploy to production, let's turn that off. The debug option is the thing that says if there's an error, an exception or something, it prints all that information for you in the browser. That's great when developing locally, but when you're running in production, it means that anybody can see that information. And sometimes that information can include things like passwords, which obviously we don't want anyone to see. So let's turn that off by setting that to false. The second thing we have to do is this setting here called allowed hosts. We need to add the new domain name that we're provisioning our website under. So mine was antspacetours.azurewebsites.net, so I can add that in here. And you'd fill in whatever it is that you've completed for your application. The next thing we need to think about is our static file. So when you're running run server locally, it's actually doing two things. First, it's running the Django application, and secondly, it's serving up any static files that you have. These would include things like CSS and JavaScript. To do that in production, what we can actually use is another package, which makes things nice and simple for us. So if you go to requirements.txt and then add a new dependency called white noise. So we're going to go back to our settings file and configure white noise. So the first thing we do is go down to the middleware section, and we add the white noise middleware, which is whitenoise.middleware.whitenoisemiddleware. The link for that will be in the notes. Next, we go right down to the bottom of this settings file to where we've declared static files and the static URL to be /static. That's the default. We need to add an extra couple of settings in here. So first, we're going to say static file storage should be using the white noise package. And then secondly, that we're going to have an extra folder that is going to get created on the production server called static files. You never need to worry about that folder. It will get generated automatically. These are just two extra settings that we need so that when we deploy it in production, it can find all the CSS files and JavaScript and things like that. So those are the two changes we need to make to our app before we can deploy into production. So let's go ahead and save those changes and then go back into the Azure pane and click on this button here to deploy to web app. It's now going to ask us which web app we want to deploy to. I've got quite a few actually, but Ant Space Tours is the one that we just created. And it's going to ask me if I want to overwrite any previous deployment. Since I haven't actually done a deployment yet, that's absolutely fine, but it will ask you that every time. So just click on the deploy button. And then it's going to ask us, instead of asking which web app you want to deploy to, shall we store a local configuration to say which one is default? So click yes. And then next time you do deploy with new changes or anything, it's not going to ask you that question a second time. So it's going to take maybe a minute or two to deploy your application and get that up and online. If you want to see all the details, you can click on this link here to see the logs as it's being deployed. And it'll tell you if there are any errors or anything when it's deploying the package. Cool, so once that's finished, you should get this notification to say that your deployment has finished. And there's a button here saying browse website, so go ahead and click on that. And there it is, your website has been deployed on the internet. So congratulations, give yourself a pat on the back. You've written your first Django app and it's up and running online. So we can see here that our functionality is done. We've got our tours, we've got our navigation here. We can look at destinations, we can go back and see the cruises. So that is looking fantastic. So congratulations. One last thing to note is that you might be wondering, what about the database? So, you know, we used a SQLite database when we set up this project. So this database that you've been working on locally is the one that has been deployed to production. So if you make any changes locally, the next time you deploy, it will push those up into production. However, if you make changes to the database in production, maybe through a form or something, and you deploy again, it will actually overwrite those changes. That's because we're using just a single simple file for our database. For a bigger project, really what you'll be looking to do is actually set up a database server. In Azure, we offer something called Postgres, which is a widely used database server available. It's an open source project, but we offer it as a service. So you can actually configure Postgres for Azure and connect your Django application. We've got plenty of tutorials on how to do that, but just to get you up and running with it nice and simple, let's stick with SQLite for the time being.